Hey, metalheads, welcome in. Do I have my horns right? Yeah, I sure do. That's how we do it, right? It is First Look, Heavy Metal Thunder, and I am Steve Buzzard, your host. So glad to be with you. We are going to bring you a band. Normally, I don't know the band, but this one I do have a little bit of history, and usually I don't do background, but I wanted to do background for this particular band. It is Suicide Silence, okay? And so if you're a big fan of the band, you may know where I'm going with this, but the song we're gonna look at today is Disengage. And it's cool for me because I got to see them in 2008. And so I quickly went to the Wikipedia page, and wouldn't you know it, their set is featured at the Mayhem Festival where I saw them. Now, I don't know if this one that I saw particularly in Sacramento, but I remember they brought it, and it was in such a way that my jaw was dropping, right? I couldn't believe the lead singer and what he could do. But here's the thing, their lead singer, Mitch Lucker, died 4 years later. In fact, was supposed to come back at Mayhem Festival in 2012, but died in a motorcycle accident. And so they have a brand new singer, Eddie Hermida, from All Shall Perish. He is the new guy. And so Suicide Silence with a brand new song. I love Disengage. Being a baseball fan, I can't help but think of the new rule in baseball when the pitcher disengages from the batter. But with that aside, we're going to have a lot of fun with this one. So again, yes, I do have a little background. Normally, that is not the case. I haven't heard this song, and I can't say that I've heard the lead singer. So, you know, I would imagine that when you go from, you know, a front man to another front man, you're going to try to keep that sound that you've had for so many years. So that's my guess. Let's see how this one plays out, because I'm looking at a lead shot, and it's strange, but it feels like it's Mitch Lucker. So I don't know what's going on here. This will be fun. Let's do it together. Without further ado, let's get to it. Well, my question is, this might be an older song, because, yeah, that's what he would do. Yeah, he'd do those arms out there. That's what I remember. Oh, this is an older song. By the way, Suicide Silence from Riverside, California. Yep. I remember this sound as if it was yesterday. Yeah, that's what I remember about him, the wet hair, and then this. Right? Yeah. There it is.
I'm sorry. That's what I remember. That's what sticks out to me. And I remember I was like stage left, just looking up and going, oh my god.
Okay, from 2010. Okay, you know what? I am glad we went that route. So I wanted to do that background because I wasn't sure that with the video, if we were going to see them with the new singer or actually get the honor of seeing that, right? Mitch Lucker, rest in peace, man. Wow. Passed away in 2012, motorcycle accident. That was from 2010, Disengage. Like I said, there are front men that just stick out to you. He's one of them. I didn't know his name at the time, but just when he did the, right? I'm just like, yep, I remember that so much. And wow, okay, well, this one, it's hidden in a different way, right? Because in a way, it's almost like nostalgic, right? Like we're kind of paying homage to a front man who's passed away. I mean, that's 11 years now. So I want to give this one a 9.1. It's just a 9.1. Yeah, it's definitely within the nines. It, like I said, just hit in a different way, not in the way that where I normally get amped, but really just to kind of sit there and just watch that performance and see that that guy, he sang with so much passion. So I'll leave it at that right there. If you're a Suicide Silence fan, maybe we'll follow it up with a song with the new lead singer, right? And kind of what we were talking about in the beginning, how will their sound be or is it now compared to what it was with the passing away of Mitch Lucker. Okay, so I'm Steve Buzzard. We'll do it again. Hope you can join us for the next one. The easy way to do it is to subscribe to the channel. Very simple, and that will just alert you. It'll drop a notification on your phone that we got brand new material. We do it on the weekly. We are very consistent, and I've always expressed my favorite part is being able to see the cover art that my producer, Michael Kenobi, comes with. He definitely comes up with some doozy. So we'll see what he does with this one. I'm kind of thinking I know what he's going to go with. All right, until next time, rock on.